Hello everyone, this video is in continuation to our videos on human reproduction for grade 12, wherein we are discussing about the various post-fertilization changes. We have discussed till the blastula formation and implantation as well. I have made this diagram for your reference. In our previous video, we have discussed that these chorionic villi are formed and they embed themselves in the endometrium. And this process, at this point, when these chronic villi will embed themselves into the endometrial wall till the maternal blood, this is known as implantation. So now till here, till implantation, the process has taken place. Now after this, the next process will start, that is gastrulation. In this video, we will talk till primitive streak formation, which is the onset or the which is the mark that okay, fine, now gastrulation has started. And in our next video, we'll talk about the formation of three germ layers. Why will we talk about it? Because gastrula is the structure in which all the three germ layers, ecto, endo and mesoderms, are completely formed. Fine. So I'll first of all, we'll quickly talk about what do you mean by gastrula. Now herein I've divided board into two parts. In this part we'll make the diagrams, and herein I'll write so that it's easy for you to write them in your notes. Fine. So we'll start up. We are going to talk about gastrulation here. So what is gastrula? First of all, what is gastrulation? Gastrulation is the formation of gastrula from a blastula. And what is the significant characteristic feature of gastrula? Gastrula has all the three germ layers, and we know there are three germ layers: ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. So throughout the process of gastrulation, we are going to discuss that how these three layers are formed. First we'll discuss ecto, then meso and endoderm, but this will be discussed in our next video. Till now we are going to cover two very important topics, that how amniotic sac is formed here in this stage and how primitive streak is formed and what is its significance. Fine. So now I have marked it as one, the first structure. Now what happens? The second structure which is formed due to a change. Now what is the change which is going to take place? Herein we see that we have flattened trophoblast cells, the embryonal knob, chronic villi, and these blue colored, the ones which I have marked with blue, they are Raubers cells. Raubers cells. What were Rauber cells? The cells of trophoblast which were placed close to the embryonic knob were known as Rauber cells. Now, what happens here in the next change which is going to take place after implantation is that the Rauber cell will degenerate. I'll not make the complete structure. We'll just not waste time in it. I'll make the place from where. Now herein I have marked them with blue. I'll just suppose these are the Rauber cells. Fine. And beneath the Rauber cells we have the embryonal knob. Now two changes will take place. One, and I'll just make this chronic villi also here to make things clear. Fine. So this is chronic villi. Now what happens? These Rauber cells, they degenerate. Fine. Now when they degenerate, we have embryonal knob here. This embryonal knob will arrange itself. We have seen that they are rounded cells which are just in the form of a cluster. Now this cluster is going to arrange itself in a planned manner. That means it is going to arrange itself in a significant layering form and will form this structure which we call as embryonal disc now, because it forms a disc like structure. And the place here, from here, the Rauber cells, they have disappeared. So this will lead to formation of a cavity here. It will form, a cavity will form here, and this cavity is the amniotic cavity. Fine. Now, what is going to happen in future now? In future, what is going to happen? This amniotic cavity is going to cover the whole structure inside it, and this embryo will start developing inside the embryonic cavity. Now, this is the amniotic cavity which will have amniotic fluid in it. Now, what happens if I show you the future view? That means what is going to now happen random? A process which will take place is that this amniotic cavity is now going to cover the whole structure and will be filled with amniotic fluid. Fine. So this is the first change which takes place, that the embryonal knob has arranged itself in a disc-like pattern. Layering of cells take place, they become elongated and get layered up. Wherein the Rauber cells were there, the Rauber cells will degenerate and amniotic cavity will form. Now, in this process, we have discussed, I'll write it with a different color. So, we have discussed gastrulation, gastrula formation. Now, what is the first change after implantation? The Rauber cells degenerate and a cavity is formed. Cavity is formed, which is called as amniotic cavity, which will further be filled with amniotic fluid, and the embryo will develop inside the amniotic cavity. Now, what happens next? This was the second change. The next thing which is going to take place, the third structure which we are going to form, is that what happens after this? What happens to the embryonal disc? Now, suppose these are the trophoblast cells, and we have made it with red. I'll make it with the red. So, this is the embryonal disc. Now, the embryonal disc, the cells of the embryonal disc will move up. Rauber cells have degenerated, thoda sa they'll move up, and we have the trophoblast cells surrounding it herein. Fine, this is the complete structure. I'm not making the complete structure as of now. So we are just going to discuss about the embryo. Now what happens? They move slightly up and they undergo a division. Division of embryonal disc will take place now. So after this, what happens? The embryonal disc undergoes division. And in this division, it forms two types of cells, epiblast cells and hypoblast cells. Epiblast cells and hypoblast cells. Out of these two cells, epiblast cells are columnar, whereas hypoblast cells are cuboidal in shape. Fine. So now what is going to happen after this? We'll just make, this is the embryonic cavity which is formed here, fine, and the disc-like structure has moved up. Now, it forms the next structure. What happens here? In this structure, the embryonal disc is going to undergo division. Now, this embryonal disc will lead to formation of one layer, which is columnar cells, the upper ones. And it will form the division will form two layers, epiblast and hypoblast. So these are columnar cells of epiblast, and I'll make hypoblast with a blue color. And the next is the cuboidal cells which are here, that is the hypoblast. So this is epiblast, and then we have hypoblast layer. Hypoblast, fine. So the division of embryonal disc has taken place and epiblast and hypoblast have formed now. After this, first of all, there are two ends of this embryonal disc. The end, this end, suppose it is the end towards the anterior side, that is known as cephalic end. Cephalic end. And the other one towards the other side, this, I'll write it with some other color. So this end is the caudal end. Caudal end. Fine. So one is the caudal. A caudal is always cauda is the posterior part, and cephalic is towards the head. So now what happens at this point of time after the division of apoblast and hypoblast? I'll just remove it for so that there is some space. Now what happens is after this division, if we you know turn this like this, if we bring the caudal end here on the front side, now what happens from the caudal end, from the suppose on this side towards the camera, we have the caudal end now. So what will happen, the cells of this embryonic disc, they will undergo this invagination from the center. This is the caudal end. From the center there'll be an invagination, and these are the cells, they'll be arranged like this. This invagination is known as the primitive streak. The invagination or the depression is known as primitive streak, and herein, from here arises this structure, and which has a knob like structure on the top. This is the primitive knob, and this is the streak which is said to have undergo the formation of notochord in future. Fine. So this is the primitive streak. Why we have discussed about this primitive streak formation here, I'll write it with red color, because it's a very important point. The two pointers we have discussed, formation of amniotic cavity and formation of primitive streak. Primitive streak formation is the initiating point, or the start is the onset or start of gastrulation. Now from herein the process of formation of germ layers will start. First ectoderm will form, then meso, and then endoderm will form. So this is the onset or start. This phase, the formation of primitive streak, is the onset of the formation of the three germ layers now, or you can say the gastrulation. Next, the significance of this primitive streak. The significance of primitive, I am writing PS for primitive streak, is that it will show bilateral symmetry, or you can say that it is responsible for bilateral symmetry in the developing embryo. In the developing embryo of mammals, we are bilaterally symmetrical. So that primitive streak, it decides that okay, fine, the organism can be equally divided into two halves. So this is the point for which determines bilateral symmetry in the developing embryo. Fine. So herein we have discussed that what changes occur for the formation of amniotic cavity. Then the embryonal disc, it undergoes division, which is also known as delamination. It undergoes division to form epiblast and hypoblast cells. There is a cephalic end and a caudal end. If we talk about the caudal end, from the caudal end, the depression of the there arises a depression in the embryonic disc, and this depression is leads to formation of a streak like structure with a knob at the top. This is known as primitive streak. The formation of primitive streak determines that now the process of gastrulation has started. So In our next video, we'll discuss the second part of gastrulation, wherein we will discuss that how the process of formation of endoderm it starts. So keep watching, liking, sharing, subscribing. Thank you.